Stand up if I have to take one.
I just messed up my hair.
We need mo- I messed up.
You thought this is a little...
Kent, section 3, take 3.
Take 2.
Unique New York. 跟别人讲话的时候，我会 Sorry, can I restart?
Every year at Bessemer, the SaaS team takes time to reflect and report on the state of the cloud. And we are beyond biased here after more than 2 decades of cloud investing. But coming up with the headline message, that's always been the easy part. The cloud's pretty good. For 10 years, the public markets reflected our enthusiasm, climbing up and to the right, tracing this incredible wave of SaaS growth. But 2021 was a year that contained 2 very different stories. First, the cloud boomed to all-time highs, not only in the public markets, but IPOs, major M&A events, and levels of company creation and venture funding hit all-time peaks, driven in large part by cloud companies. But then in November, things began to change.
Driven by inflation and fears of rising interest rates, not to mention geopolitical instability, the Bessemer Cloud Index lost 40% of its peak value in just a few months. At Bessemer, we've been calling it the Sassacre. We'll point out that public cloud stocks, even after the Sassacre, have still outperformed major indexes over the past few years. But the dramatic pullback is having real consequences in the world of private cloud startups. After a record IPO year in 2021, there were no SaaS IPOs through the first week of April 2022. And the private investing pace dipped in the first quarter, leading many of us to prepare our portfolio companies for a more challenging financing environment in the quarters ahead. But then again, we're not sure the private markets will slow down anytime soon. 2021 was the largest VC fundraising year to date. The market saw VC firms raise 2 of the largest funds ever at the beginning of the year. There's an enormous amount of capital earmarked for largely SaaS-based investing, and so the private markets may ignore the public market's signal, at least for a while.
So where the heck does this leave the state of the cloud? We struggle at times to tell the real story of the cloud because headlines are so focused on IPOs, fundraisings, and of course, the dreaded daily unicorn tally. Because while the financing climate matters, it is far from the only thing that matters. So today, we'll spend most of our time on the more fundamental trends we see impacting cloud products beyond simply financing. First, we'll do a refresher on the SaaS model and the trends that we see impacting both cloud businesses and their go-to-market strategy. Then we'll take a look at the macro trends driving cloud adoption and new company formation. Next, we'll look at a perspective on how the cloud is truly spreading around the world. And finally, we'll ask ourselves whether there might be a better way to measure the health of the cloud than just counting unicorns.
Spoiler alert, there is. If you want to dive into the full report, go to bvp.com/atlas/stateofthecloud2022. Let's get started.
We know most of you don't need a SaaS 101 lecture, but whenever we see the world staring too hard at the SaaS valuation roller coaster, we think it's helpful to step back, take a look at the fundamentals, and remind ourselves why the hell we spend so much time talking about this 4-letter word. SaaS lets us deliver software through the internet, making it available everywhere with products that continuously improve to take advantage of the latest that the cloud has to offer. And the rental business model drives companies to focus obsessively on customer needs and earn their trust every day. When all of this comes together just right, we think SaaS is arguably the best business model on the planet. Top SaaS companies perform an investment miracle so routinely that we take it for granted. For every dollar they hand to a sales team, they see a dollar of recurring revenue materialize in less than a year and grow nearly in perpetuity. That miracle is why these businesses are valued at 10 to 20 times revenue, even in today's market. Thus, at these multiples, each dollar invested in growth can create tens of dollars of enterprise value every year. To underline this point, we couldn't help ourselves but dig into the data. We calculated the annual return that BVP Cloud Index companies generated on a gross margin basis relative to their sales and marketing investments last year. Based on our conservative assumptions, the average BVP Cloud Index company generated a 68% IRR for every dollar they invested in sales and marketing. This isn't a perfect return on cash metric, but we think it illustrates just how efficiently these companies can recycle capital, particularly when compared with the average S&P 500 company that is striving just to reach a 20% return on capital. Top-performing cloud companies saw returns well north of 100% IRR, and not just fast-growing, product-led companies like Datadog or Zoom. More mature companies like Shopify still returned over 100% last year, simply by investing sales and marketing dollars behind a killer product. So clearly, the power of this model endures over time. The SaaS model isn't just strong, it's getting stronger every year as SaaS companies roll out improved functionality and find new ways to make money. Every day, the internet improves. More bandwidth, more data, more APIs, and increasingly, more access to AI, powering everything from image recognition to language generation. And so every day, the SaaS products we build on this fabric grow more powerful. Many of these new capabilities also open up new business models. Years ago, a handful of established SaaS companies were bold enough to explore payments and lending as a second act. These companies found that integrating adjacent financial services not only improved the stickiness of their product, but also became a dominant revenue driver over time. As the secret of the SaaS model has gotten out, many markets are increasingly competitive. We predict that the winners in these markets will be the ones that lean into indirect monetization from day one and reduce their SaaS fees where possible by instead tapping into other adjacent pools of spend. Thanks to the proliferation of APIs, it is easier than ever to build products that monetize indirectly on a range of services, including embedded payroll, card issuing, insurance, logistics, and even banking solutions. In some rare cases, companies are even jumping to completely free software as a lead generation tactic to capture more lucrative indirect monetization streams. It has also never been easier to access the cloud, regardless of a customer's sophistication, thanks to these three trends. First, early adopters continue moving increasingly sensitive data like security logs and financial records to the cloud, which would have been nearly unthinkable a decade ago. Second, thanks to the portability and broader adoption of containers, it's easier to package SaaS apps and deploy them inside a customer's private cloud, satisfying some more conservative cloud adopters. And third, middleware is extending the reach of the cloud, allowing legacy systems in old school industries like banking, supply chain, logistics, and healthcare to remain on-prem while taking advantage of the connectivity and intelligence capabilities in the cloud. All of this just expands the addressable market for cloud businesses. Finally, while the cloud has long been associated with the powerful trends around product-led growth, we are also seeing the cloud become increasingly critical as a sales fulfillment channel. Yes, the cloud is helping us sell more cloud. Public cloud marketplaces have emerged as one of the most natural places for SaaS buyers and sellers to transact, regardless of whether it's a bottoms-up purchase or a large enterprise deal. It is still early innings for this trend. In 2021, we saw $4 billion of marketplace transactions, growing three times faster than the public cloud itself. But this still represents less than 1% of total cloud transactions. Cloud marketplace platform Tackle forecasts that we will continue to see these marketplaces pick up speed, growing to $50 billion of GMV by 2025. We predict that cloud marketplace procurement will go fully mainstream and become a standard component of the SaaS go-to-market playbook. Last year, less than half of the Cloud 100 companies were selling through cloud marketplaces. And we predict that by the end of next year, the vast majority of Cloud 100 companies will be marketplace sellers. So cloud products, monetization models, delivery methods, and sales channels are all improving and providing even better customer experiences in the process. Thus, it's not surprising to see enterprise demand for IT continue to rise, with the cloud still clearly on track to become the largest spend category within all of IT.
The SaaS product and business model are healthier than ever. But is the current volatile macroclimate good or bad news for the cloud? And how much runway does the cloud have left in the global economy? The world is in a strange place right now. The COVID pandemic drove an unprecedented churn in global labor markets. Widespread initial job losses were followed by the Great Resignation and incredible labor shortages. Just last month, the US quit rate neared a 20-year high, while the unemployment rate dropped to the lowest level since 1969. This is on the back of a long-term trend of declining birth rates and an aging population. And unfortunately, it's not just the supply of labor that's in question. The supply of, well, pretty much everything else, from microchips to imported goods to oil and even wheat, is in question at the moment. The cloud certainly can't solve all the world's problems, but we can predict that cloud software will play a pivotal role in closing the gap of global productivity. We see three obvious opportunities for the cloud to have an impact on the macro picture. Number one, the global supply chain is on fire. And yet, 50% of US importers still use simple spreadsheets to manage their business. Meanwhile, over 90% of Fortune 500 C-suites report having plans to increase resilience in their supply chain this year. This environment is ripe for adoption of SaaS products to help manage the global supply chain. Second, with labor markets as competitive as ever, remote and hybrid work, once thought to be a temporary COVID response, is here to stay. Across the Bessemer portfolio, we don't know of any company which has turned back the clock on a remote or hybrid policy. And cloud software is a critical ingredient in this new workplace. And finally, for individuals on the other side of the Great Resignation, with over 50% of younger generations expecting to freelance in the future, 1 billion freelancers are leveraging creator and builder tools to monetize their talents. The cloud has been around for over 20 years now and offers obvious benefits for global productivity. So it must be reaching some level of saturation by now, right? Not quite. Low cloud penetration rates across different industries in the US market show just how far the cloud economy has left to go. And as of 2021, Toast, the leading SaaS platform for restaurants, had only penetrated 6% of US restaurants. Even in the US, cloud adoption is still in the early innings. And when we pan out and look at global markets, we see even more runway for cloud adoption. North America has the highest rate of IT spending on public cloud, with 15%, which represents 55% of global public cloud spending. Europe represents 26% of the global cloud market and spends 10% of its IT budget on cloud. In comparison, APAC contributes to 1/3 of global GDP, but is just over 15% of global public cloud spend, at only 4.7% of local IT budgets. Across the Middle East and North Africa, cloud spend is even less at 2.8% of total IT spend. Bessemer believes that the cloud will continue to sweep the globe, and we have active SaaS investors on the ground in the US, Europe, Israel, India, and China. All the markets that have seen multiple cloud players that have surpassed the 100 million revenue mark. Although we believe the cloud will continue to penetrate the global economy, it's increasingly clear that not every cloud provider will grow globally. And the companies that do expand into new markets, they must pay especially close attention to adapting their product, go-to-market strategy, and customer needs to the new region. Given the importance of localization, especially in vertical software, we see the rise of several regional this-of-that cloud players and expect to see more in the future. However, as the cloud continues its global march, it's clear that the world needs better software to coordinate the economy, and that the global cloud is only getting started. For more detail on trends in specific geographies from our investors on the ground in Europe, Israel, India, and China, be sure to go to this link for the full report.
For years, the tech industry has measured the health of the cloud with the world's favorite metric, money. But the stampede to earn a unicorn valuation is getting out of hand. Almost a decade ago, when Aileen Lee coined the term, unicorns were an elite group of billion-dollar companies with meaningful revenue leaving an undeniable imprint on the global economy. Today, that's not quite the case. From 2020 to 2021, we saw a 120% increase in unicorns, which is essentially 1.5 unicorns created per day last year. Today, there are more than 1,000 unicorns in the world, many of them with less than $1 million of revenue. The only thing we can truly conclude about a unicorn today is their ability to attract investor interest.
We're all about startups getting their due, but this unicorn or bust mentality has unfortunately driven many startups to focus on valuation, not building a great business as their primary goal. And unfortunately, there are shortcuts available to juice near-term valuation at the cost of long-term startup health. We need a new milestone, one more aligned with building a lasting business. That's why at Bessemer, we're introducing the Centaur, a new cloud milestone reserved for SaaS businesses that hit 100 million of annual recurring revenue. At 100 million ARR, the startup is an undeniable success. At 100 million ARR, these companies have found product market fit, built a scalable organization, and reached a critical mass of customers.
At Bessemer, we've identified approximately 150 private Centaurs within the cloud ecosystem, making this class of startup almost 7 times more rare than a unicorn. And these companies endure. In the past 10 years, 55 SaaS Centaurs have IPO'd, and of those, 52 remain standalone public companies. 3 have been acquired, and 0 have shut down. Unicorns haven't been so lucky. Nearly 20% of unicorns founded between 2005 and 2018 subsequently wound down or saw their valuations fall back to earth. Centaurs are immortal, unicorns are not. Most importantly, we think centaurs more accurately signal the true health of the cloud economy. Compare the birth rates of unicorns versus centaurs. Last year, unicorn creation went off the charts as the market peaked, only to fall to earth this year following the Sasaker crash. Over the same time period, the birth rate of centaurs steadily accelerated and is on pace in 2022 to continue this steady climb. Because centaur status is driven by business fundamentals, the centaur count is immune from the volatility of fundraising markets.
And we're excited to report that so far, despite the macro volatility, 2022 is on pace to be a record year for centaur creation. In the years ahead, we'll continue to track and report on the Centaur universe as we watch the cloud mature. So how do you become a Centaur? The good news is that there isn't one way to do it. We've seen enduring companies take a variety of paths to Centaur status over the years, ranging from a few years to over 10 to scale from 1 million to 100 million ARR. For further information on how to reach Centaur status, go to bvp.com/centaur, where you get the go-to resources for business growth. There, you'll find the entire State of the Cloud 2022 report, including this year's predictions and deep dives on different geographies.
As we close out this year's State of the Cloud, we'll make one more prediction. 2022 will be the year of the Centaur. Volatility is likely to continue, at least in the public markets. With this in mind, many overhyped unicorns may feel the headwinds and challenge to grow into the most recent valuation. But here's the silver lining. We expect the VC and founder community will begin to turn their attention back to SaaS fundamentals, where great products drive loyal, engaged customers, and where there is efficient growth of good old-fashioned revenue.
So, there you have it, our State of the Cloud 2022. Despite the stormy financial skies, at Bessemer, we think the state of the cloud is strong and growing stronger every day with an enormous runway ahead of it. So to all the cloud founders, ignore the headlines. Just keep building and let us know how we can help.